The Very Hungry Caterpillar by Eric Carle, creatively read and adapted by Lorenzo. Today's story time is a tribute to one great author and illustrator of children's books, Eric Carle. The Very Hungry Caterpillar is one of the greatest childhood classics of all time. In the light of the moon, a little egg lay on a leaf. One Sunday morning, the warm sun came up, and pop out of the egg came a tiny and very hungry caterpillar. He started to look for some food. On Monday, he ate through one apple, but he was still hungry. On Tuesday, he ate through two pears, but he was still hungry. On Wednesday, he ate through three plums, but he was still hungry. On Thursday, he ate through four strawberries, but he was still hungry. On Friday, he ate through five oranges, but he was still hungry. On Saturday, he ate through one piece of chocolate cake, one ice cream cone, one pickle, one slice of Swiss cheese, one slice of salami, one lollipop, one piece of cherry pie, one sausage, one cupcake, and one slice of watermelon. That night, he had a stomachache. The next day was Sunday again. The caterpillar ate through one green leaf, and after that, he felt much better. Now he wasn't hungry anymore, and he wasn't a little caterpillar anymore. He was a big, fat caterpillar. He built a small house called a cocoon around himself. He stayed inside for more than 2 weeks. Then he nibbled a hole in the cocoon, pushed his way out, and he was a beautiful butterfly! The end. Now it's time to start the quiz. What did the caterpillar eat first? An apple, a pear, or a cupcake? The answer is an apple. What did the caterpillar eat last? A piece of pie, an orange, or a leaf? The answer is a leaf. How long did the caterpillar stay in the cocoon? 2 days, more than 2 weeks, or about a month? The answer is more than 2 weeks. Where did the egg start out? On the ground, in a tree, or on a leaf? The answer is on a leaf. How did the caterpillar feel after eating a lot? Sick, happy, or sad? The answer is sick. Superb! Your hard work has paid off. Discover your favorite bedtime story creatively read by me. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, like and subscribe.